Hello, Les from Thailand here. Today's video is going to be about my marriage visa and the 6 attempts it took to get my marriage visa. But I've eventually got it now, some 7 months after I first applied for it. So at the end of the video, I'll give you the information, and I think it's quite important information as to what can happen at the end of the day, on the final day when they come and visit you before they give you the nod to say yes, you've got your visa. So the reason for me going from a retirement visa to a marriage visa was because of the 800,000 baht and the 65,000 baht a month that you have to show. Now, I don't live on 65,000 baht a month. I live on 50,000 baht a month, so I didn't want to transfer over 65,000 baht a month over to my account just to please the immigration department when I live on 50,000 baht a month. So the obvious solution for me was to go down the marriage visa, or that's the solution that I thought would be the easiest. Boy, was I wrong. It just 7 months it took a long time before I've got it. But briefly, I'll go through why it took so long. So just before my retirement visa was finished, I went down to immigration to ask them what I needed with regard to a marriage visa. So it was the obvious. There's lists on Google as to what information you need to take, marriage documentation, blue books of my wife, etc., etc., etc. So we had all of that information. We went down to the immigration department. They wanted 3 months income into my bank account from overseas. No problem. So I gave them 6 months income from my bank statement from Bangkok Bank. And they noticed on one of the statements that I got paid twice in December. Now, my pension gets paid every month from the fire brigade into my account. So what we did in December, because we get paid twice in December because of the Christmas and New Year period, they pay me twice in December. So we were on holiday in Chiang Mai. So what I did 4 days before it was due to come into the January's pay, I drew my salary for that month early. So we had a bit more spending money in Chiang Mai. But on paper, it looks as if I didn't get anything in January. So the immigration department says, no, we can't give you your immigration for marriage visa because you haven't got over 40,000 baht in your account every month. Because January you didn't get paid. So I showed them for the past 6 months I get paid every month, but in December I got paid twice, and it shows in December that I got paid twice. Immigration, no. So what they did, they extended my retirement visa for 3 months, and then they said I have to show at least 40,000 baht coming into my account every month. All the paperwork was okay, no problem with the paperwork. So again, 90 days later, I went back down to immigration, maybe it was a week or so before, just to make sure I had all the paperwork. And then she went through all the paperwork. Yeah, happy at that. Okay, so when we come in the next time, she said, I need to have a witness. You need to have a witness here to show that they know you and they sign the documentation to say that they know you and how long they've known you for. So, okay, next time we go down, we check the witness with us. Sat in the office for an hour, she goes through all the paperwork, and then she says, okay, where's your electricity bill? I said, we don't have an electricity bill. The landlady pays the electricity bill, we pay the landlady. I want to see your electricity bill. And she said, I also want to see a picture of you and the witness at your house, inside the house and outside the house. So on that occasion, I said, okay, if we go get the electricity bill, which isn't in my name, it's in the landlady's name, and a photograph of our witness, can we have the visa? She said, yes, no problem. So it was an hour and 20 minutes from the immigration department to where we live. But then there was one more question I had to ask, because I had to go back to England during the month of consideration, whether that would be acceptable. Straight away, the woman looked at me and she says, no. No, not acceptable. You cannot leave the country during that month of consideration because we might need to get in touch with you. So then she called the head of immigration and the lady came out and I said to her, listen, my mother was seriously ill. I had to go back to England and I can't guarantee that I'll be back home within that month. She says, no, because you're leaving the country, you can't do it. So then she said, you have to go outside of the country and start an old visa based on marriage from another embassy. She suggested the one in London. And then she gave me a note to say that I had 7 days in which to leave the country because my visa had expired by then. So very unhappy, I left the office and booked a flight and went home back to England for a month. And then I applied for an O visa and I got the O visa based on marriage. Then I came back to Thailand and then 90 days later, with all the paperwork again, went back down to the immigration office, asked them, is this all correct? Is this all that you want? And they said, yes, okay, we need the witness again. So we took the witness again, backed her down to the immigration office. Bearing in mind, she'd already looked at all the paperwork and said, yeah, okay, then we'll see you the next time you come with your witness. So we get back to the office and she said, where's your pension letter? My fire brigade pension. I said, I understand you don't need my pension letter because the embassy doesn't stamp it anymore. So therefore my proof of income is my money from foreign transfers, which it says clearly states on my bank account from Bangkok Bank, foreign transfer, over 40,000 baht. She says, no, I need to go and see your visa. Not your visa, I need to go and see your pension statement, where your money comes from. And I said, you didn't ask for this last week. She said, well, I want to see it. So then an hour and 20 minutes drive back home, gets the pension letter, an hour and 20 minutes drive back to the immigration office, sat with the immigration lady for another 35, 40 minutes. And then she goes through everything and she says, yep, okay, we'll send it away to Bangkok, but you will get a visit from immigration department. Fair enough, don't mind that. So a week later, immigration department rang up. Now the lady in the office said they'll give you 24 hours notice from when they ring you up. So if they rang on a Thursday, they'll be there on a Friday. They rang at 10 o'clock in the morning, said we'll be there afternoon. We want to see the witness that you had in the office at your house. So our witness that signed the documentation in the office lives 25, 30 kilometers away. So a quick phone call to them and thankfully she was available. So they came up to our house. Half an hour before the immigration department arrived, they said, we need another witness. We don't need the person who came into the office. We need somebody totally new, your next door neighbor or somebody like that. Half an hour before they were due to arrive. So my wife on the motorbike looked for our next door neighbors, who all the time is never going to be in. So she tried three or four different people to say, can you come and act as a witness in front of the immigration police? Two of them says no, because they're scared of the police. They don't want anything to do with the police. So we eventually found one who came and said, yes, we'll sit in front of the police, tell them what they want to know. It just so happened it was the landlady's gardener who came and verified, yeah, I know them, they've lived here now for nearly 2 years. So yeah, they signed all the documentation and another at least 10 photographs of me, the new witness, the old witness, the immigration officers inside the house, outside the house and by the address. So once that was done, that was it. We waited 3 more weeks after that and thankfully our visa had arrived and this it was granted for 12 months marriage visa. So just to those people who are thinking of going to the marriage visa route, it's complicated, it's tedious, it's full of paperwork, all I can say is just grit your teeth. This is what they want. It's up. It's their country. They can ask whatever they want to do. So you just smile and say yes, okay, because it's nothing too difficult at the end of the day. If they want to see documentation, you're just going to see their documentation. But it just goes to show that we went down to the office 3 times in total to say, this is the paperwork, have we got everything correct for the next time we come, and then we can go through the process. And twice they said, yes, you've got all the paperwork. And then when we went to fill in all the paperwork, no, you haven't got all the paperwork. I want to see this, I want to see that. It's like a lot of people say on Thai visa, each office interprets the law to their own tastes, and they will ask for, like, electricity bill. It never says anything anywhere to see that they want to see in the electricity bill, but this is what she wanted to see, so that's what we provided, was the electricity bill. And so be prepared for anything and everything. Check more than enough paperwork, so if they ask, you can just give it to them. So it's still worth jumping through the hoops to stay in this country. I love this country, and I'm on my year's marriage visa now, and hopefully next year it should go through a little bit simpler than this year. So do persist, it's worth the effort in the end, but it's their country. They can ask for whatever paperwork they want. So until the next time, good luck with your visa application. Hope everything goes well. And from Les, retired and still living the dream in Thailand, until the next time, bye for now.